Hi, this is Glenda. I finally got around to playing with some more of the lace, the wire lace mesh, which looks like this that I mentioned in a earlier video. I started playing, trying to make butterflies. This was my first attempt, and it wasn't great. And the reason it has beads on it is to cover up how crooked it is in the middle. So while I was also in wire mode, I tried crocheting a flower in wire, and I will have another go at that. It doesn't look like a flower, but as a flower center, it does something. I'm hoping it will show up, but there's little tiny bits of the, what do you call it, fleshing it out, the very narrowest of these wire lace, just as a little embellishment. So there's one attempt. These two I made more or less at the same time, and I've been trying different gauges of wire, so I sort of decided that probably the 20, no, 30, try again, this one, the 24 gauge was not a bad size to use for the frames, and then I used the 34 gauge for the centers. So all they are is loops, and you put the lace wire, the wire lace, sorry, over it, and twist it together. I will try and show you, but these are the only ones I've made, so I'm by far far from expert at the whole process. I probably think this one turned out the best of them, but the other thing I did here was thread a die cut through the wire lace. That's the 6 mil one. That shows you sort of how far you can stretch it. I wouldn't do it again because the wire lace is a quite expensive product, and for things like the butterflies, you actually only use a little bit, so it ends up not too bad. But of course, for this, I used a much longer length. But I wanted to try it, but it was really fiddly getting it through. Using the wider one would have been easier. So that was those attempts. Then I also tried the same sort of idea as a flower, and hopefully that will show up and you can see how delicate it looks, but it's the same idea, just four loops with the wire lace on it. So I'll see if I can show you this. If you're only going to buy one size of this, I think the 6 millimeter is a good size to get. It's pretty versatile. I had no trouble getting it over these loops to make. If you're only going to do little embellishments, it works out a lot cheaper than the next one, which is the 12 mil. But it's a little bit fiddlier, so I'll use the 12 mil for the demonstration purposes. But so that's the aqua and the green. Comes in all sorts of colours. And this one's about $7 a metre, whereas the wider one I think was $12 a yard. Yeah, so that's the 6 mil and this is the 12 mil. But I mean, that's obviously much easier to thread. Just depends on your budget, I guess. So all I've done is take a length of wire, which I haven't measured. This one's probably a bit long, but anyway. And I'm going to put it round two fingers twice. I'm going to leave it a little bit longer than that. And then twist it together. Try not to cut off the circulation. Open it out. And you probably want to give it another twist. This is really haphazard, and I'm sure people can refine this a lot. It's just what I've been fluffing around with. So I'm just sort of twisting it a bit. It doesn't really matter. Cut off the excess, and you want to try and tuck it in so that you don't catch the lace at all. Yeah, I've cut it off too much. Because you're going to twist this again, it doesn't matter particularly how secure it is. I know that sounds ridiculous, but it really doesn't. Just try not to have anything that will catch. Now you can narrow it a bit because you can always widen it out again later. You're just going to open up the end of your wire lace, thread this in. As I said, just be careful not to catch it on anything in the middle. It did take a little bit more care before. Blasé about it now because I've done three. So I've put my lace in, my frame in there, so I don't want to waste any, so I'm going to pull it down to the end a little bit, twist it, because it's wire it will just twist up like this. Now you want to stretch it a bit because you're going to be pulling it out and you want that really loose lacy look. You can just cut it with scissors. So I'm cutting, leaving a couple of mil at the end. I'm going to twist it again. So, I mean, that used, what, about 3 inches or so of lace, which is not too bad. Then what I've been doing is putting a little bit of glossy accents on the twists and letting it set. I can find my pin because this clogs up constantly. Would you believe I cleared it just before I started filming? And then what I've been doing is letting it set, which I won't do now. So you can then pull out the frame there on both ends. See, that's come undone again, but it really won't matter. Because what we're going to do is twist the middle of it again. And you can give it a couple of twists. That's my first pair of wings, so get the glue off. Know why my twists are not staying twisted. I'm sure there is some technical reason. I really don't do much in the way of wire work. As you can probably tell. Dodgy, but never mind. As I said, you can do exactly the same thing with the 6mm and it works quite well, but it is just that little bit fiddlier to thread it through. This one's much neater than the first. Not exactly even, but never mind. As people love to say, it's handmade and doesn't need to be perfect. So I prefer to leave this a little bit longer, but never mind. So we're just going to trim off the excess. And because this is wire, you can just bend that in. And it's reasonably neat. If you do feel it's not secure enough, just put a bit more glossy accents on it after you've bent it in. But so far, so good. So, then we want the thinner wire, which as I said is 34 gauge, because you want something thin enough to thread through some beads. I don't know, 6 or 7 inches in length. So you want to put a bead on the wire. Take that down to the middle. And then the next beads will go through both wires, and that first one will hold them on. Well, if I can find the hole. I did use all crystal beads on the other ones, and they were much easier to thread. Every time I find it, I lose it again. These beads are much for much younger eyes than mine. And I need my grandson to come and do it for me. Well, they are truly painful. Okay, I shall get some more crystal beads. What I did was separate these and just wind one of them around both sets of wings and bring it up, and then put another bead, which I will have to get. Okay, and then you either need one or two beads there. I think one will do here. Then you bring them together again. So what I've done is is use one wire to twist around, one wire to bring in front with a bead on it, and then you put another bead on both wires. Okay, so then I just put a little bit more of the glossy accents, glossy accents. Just put a little bit more on the bead and let it set, and then you can just bend the feelers, cut them even and bend them to shape, and pull the wings out the way you want them. With the wire you can shape them. And you get the idea, I hope, of how to do the lace wire, the wire lace butterflies. So you can see I've added a bit of dimension by bending it. And if you want to do the flower, you simply twist the two together or I think I just hot glued one on top of the other to make the flower, and then put a stone in the middle and stuck it down. So that's my playing that I've been doing. I've been waiting to play with this lovely stuff again, and I will definitely be hopefully playing with it a bit more. Thanks for watching.